One of the most important things you need to look at when you're picking seed varieties for your farm is what are the defensive traits that I need, and are those defensive traits in the seed varieties I'm going to plant in my operation?
Well, the big thing, Brian, is to look at defensive traits that you just can't replace with crop protection products. For example, let's look at corn. I think about Goss's Wilt as one of those absolute must-haves for me when I think about hybrid protection. If I don't have good varietal tolerance for this, I just can't stop it. There's no treatment for a bacterial disease like Goss's Wilt that's been consistently effective. So I want to find traits like that that I just can't replace. Now, let's say you have northern corn leaf blight tolerance and you have one hybrid that has a little more tolerance than another. That's a nice feature to have, but it's not a must-have for me because I can use foliar fungicides to protect my crop against northern corn leaf blight.
All right, Darren brought up an excellent and, quite frankly, the most important point. When can we not solve that problem with anything else other than the defensive trait of my seed? Well, a lot of times we're talking to farmers about soybeans, and people will say, hey, I have iron deficiency chlorosis, I have to have a great bean for it, and I'm gonna agree with that if they have IDC. But here's the thing. While there may be no crop protection products that can solve the IDC problem, there absolutely are management problems that can long-term fix the soil, which will eliminate the iron deficiency chlorosis. So if you simply get your soil pH down below 7, iron deficiency chlorosis goes away. So all of a sudden now you don't even need that defensive trait anymore. So the reason why we're talking about this today is, yes, you've got to pick good varieties for your farm. You've got to look at defensive traits, but we also want you thinking about the long-term impact of decisions you make on your farm. If you just are renting ground, for example, okay, you got to just live with what you got. But let's say you own the ground. And let's say that you can get that soil pH down, so now you don't have to pick the very best IDC bean. If all of a sudden, instead of you can only pick from 5 different beans that are good on IDC, to now you can pick from 50 different soybean genetics that all could be good on your farm if you don't have IDC, well, who do you think's gonna win? The person that can pick from 5 or the person that can pick from 50? So yes, we're talking about this today, and yes, we're saying pick good defensive traits, but we're also saying, let's look at how do we long-term make a fix on our farm, make an adjustment on our farm, correct our soil on our farm, so we don't have to necessarily pick those defensive traits anymore.
All right, that's great, Brian, but again, we do farm in the real world here, and there are some situations that just aren't gonna get fixed overnight. Even if you do have, say, a drainage problem, and that's great to get tile in the ground, but it's gonna take several years for some of these problems to go away in most cases. I look at anthracnose stalk rot. Wow, has there been an improvement in varietal tolerance, but not every hybrid has got that. And if I don't have that hybrid tolerance, even with the great seed treatment, I just can't be 100% on anthracnose protection. So that's another one that I think is a real key. It's really stood out in 2018 and 2019. I think it's going to be a big factor on corn performance in 2020 as well. So having some stalk rot tolerance, especially to anthracnose, is another real key trait that I'm looking for. Now, when it comes to soybeans, boy, there are a lot of things there that really make a difference from one variety to the other. I do think the plant structure is an even bigger deal than most people are giving credit to. When I'm looking at soybean varieties, that's one of the biggest things I'm looking at. What kind of structure is it? Yes, it has to have yield. But once we've gotten that hurdle crossed, I want to look at what is my standability like? What kind of branches do I have? Are they big lateral branches or are they upright? For the most part, I like upright branching that holds relatively tight. That way I know that I can get some air movement through my plant. I know I can get sunlight down a little bit lower in the canopy. And what I'm seeing is I'm getting potting, not just at the top of the plant, but all the way through. These are things you can't buy and you can't replace with crop protection or fertility.
Here's the last thing I wanted to bring up. It's great talking about pick the right varieties with the defensive traits you need. But the problem is nobody knows how good these defensive traits are in a lot of cases because the variety is brand new. So you're totally counting on that seed company. And do you really think the seed company has all the background, all the data, all the information to tell you for sure this one is better on IDC, or for sure this one is better on anthracnose or sclerotinia white mold. Unless it's truly a resistance thing, then I don't know. I don't necessarily believe that all the time. So this is one of the reasons why we talk all the time about spread your risk, plant a lot of different varieties if you're planting mainly new stuff on your farm.
Well, I like the idea of diversification in many aspects in farming. One of them would be with weed control. We'll show you what'll stop this tough weed coming up next.